I do feel that good lawyers, they do provide a very important role in the society by helping people provide justice. It's very difficult to find good lawyers because good lawyers are very, very few and very high in demand. So I hope with this we'll be able to produce many more good lawyers who will be able to, you know, help help people get justice. We want to make this absolutely the best global law college in the world.
The proposed OP Jindal Global University will be a non-profit private university. JGU will be the first global university not only in Haryana but also in all of India. There are four specific objectives of a global university that our university seeks to foster: global programs, global collaborations, global curriculum, and global interaction. Accomplishing these objectives will enable the state of Haryana to become a provider of international education and a leader in transnational knowledge economy. The university has a global mission that is unparalleled by other public or private universities in India. This global mission is already recognized by many institutions worldwide and has enabled OP Jindal Global University to develop international collaborations with the United Nations University, Harvard University, Yale University, New York University, King's College London, the University College of University of Oxford, and many other reputed universities and educational institutions worldwide. No other university in the world has envisaged such levels of global collaboration at its formative stage. And these collaborations position the state of Haryana to situate itself within the global networks of academic excellence and assume an extraordinary leadership role in the field of higher education. Our university aims to attract internationally accomplished faculty and students.
This global law school will soon make its mark. The one point that Raj Kumar made, that lawyers were in the forefront of the freedom movement and the need to rediscover the passion for social service. And I hope that the Jindal Law School will certainly, while it imparts legal education in, you know, the traditional, the conventional sense of the term, will also look at the public service stream like Harvard Law School is doing and make it attractive enough for these young boys and girls to take it up on a full-time basis. We do need these young minds, motivated young minds, enthusiastic personalities to work on larger social issues. If there is one area the Global Law School, the Jindal Global Law School, can provide leadership, it is in training young lawyers for public service.
Our founding fathers, Mahatma Gandhi was a barrister, Jawaharlal Nehru was a barrister, C.R. Das was a barrister.
Okay.
But Sardar Patel also was a barrister. His brother, Mr. Rai Patel, was also a barrister. So they were all leading lawyers. And they always believed that India should have a constitution which should enshrine the best values. This is the wish that I have got as a Minister of Law and Justice, that our country should be the best country for justice as well as for legal knowledge, because who defends the society, who restores the righteousness, the dharma, it is the lawyer. And if the lawyer's quality is good, then society is safe. So I'm very happy that Professor Raj Kumar and others have gathered today, and I think this is the beginning of the long journey we have got ahead of it.
But it took the visionary leadership of Mr. Naveen Jindal to transform this fabulous vision into a realistic and planned institutional project. I had the pleasure of corresponding with Naveen Jindal as a founding member of the International Board of Advisors, and am proud and profoundly impressed by this new generation of impatient, smart, socially conscious, and extraordinarily successful young Indian leaders. How often have I revealed my enthusiasm about Jindal Global Law School to friends and colleagues who have their experiences in India, and when I tell them that a new university, beginning with a law school, staffed by outstanding world-class faculty, carrying out cutting-edge research, and preparing the most talented students for careers at the top of their profession, will be up and running by September 2009, they respond with a skeptical, yeah, sure. Others have seen the future and are delighted to learn of yet another example of the new incredible India, that's with an exclamation point in the middle of incredible, eh? Where especially young talent is building a confident, dynamic future.
I'm struck by the convergence of the vision guiding the O.P. Jindal Global University and the Jindal Global Law School, and our vision for the Center for International Governance Innovation, which I founded in 2002, which currently is Canada's largest foreign policy think tank with over 60 researchers. The world's capacity to understand and manage change needs urgent upgrading, and institutions like the O.P. Jindal Global University and Law School and CG and the Balsillie schools can make an important contribution to those goals. I hope I managed to stimulate your thinking and imaginations. Finally, I hope as well that this evening will mark the beginning of a fruitful and profitable collaboration between the Center of Excellence in Waterloo and the O.P. Jindal Global University. And